Shiny, uniform, lightly salty, and very tasty. The black caviar that comes from this sturgeon farm is popular around the country. It is here in the Snake River Valley in Idaho that Leo Ray started his sturgeon farm business in 1988.
The most they will be at the end of the first year is a pound. The second year they'll get up to 4 pounds, 5 pounds.
Though sturgeon farming is profitable, the wait for a return on investment is quite long, and that drives up the price of caviar.
It'll take 10 years before these are ready for producing caviar.
Ray has been a fish farmer for more than 50 years. He started his first catfish farm in California in 1968, then moved to Idaho. He says the water here is cleaner and the conditions for farming fish are perfect.
We have one down there that weighs about 400 pounds. This one weighs about 120.
Before the roe is extracted, farmers need to check whether it's ripe enough. For that, they use ultrasound or a biopsy. If the roe passes the test, the sturgeon is killed and cut down to extract sacks of roe. Extracting roe from a living fish is prohibited.
A fish naturally does it. Her body develops hormones just like a woman's body develops hormones to deliver a baby. That's when a fish releases her eggs. But to duplicate that and make the fish release the eggs so that you can just suction them out, you will have to inject her with hormones, which in the United States is not legal.
After the roe is extracted, it goes through a strainer.
And you're going to put it on here over the plate that you see underneath here. Underneath here is a plate with holes in it, and the eggs stop here, and any water or drippings drip through into this pan. And then underneath this bowl is ice.
Ice is necessary. The colder the roe is, the better. After it is sorted, employees wash the batch and clean it. Then salt is added. At this stage, the caviar is edible.
This is probably going to be maybe a pound. Maybe pound and a half. We sell it for a dollar a gram.
Finally, the caviar is packed into metal tins and glass jars and put into an ice room, where it is kept until it is ready to be sold at restaurants and stores across America. For Lesia Bakalets in Snake River Valley, Idaho, NRI's VOA News.